Kiteboarding is the world's fastest growing water sport. You can see it in inland lakes, rivers, bays, as well as any ocean around the world. People are also using kites on the snow with snowboards and skis. Hi, I'm Trip Foreman with Real Kiteboarding, and over the next 3 days, we'll be taking the Zero to Hero Kite Camp. Zero to Hero was developed by Real here in Cape Hatteras, North Carolina, to help beginners get into the sport of kiteboarding. This camp makes the sport extremely accessible for men and women ages 8 to upwards of 70 years old. This camp teaches you everything from how to launch the kite, land it, fly it, control the kite, how all the safety systems work, all the rules of responsibility that you need to know about operating a full-size kite. Then we take the kite into the water, relaunch the kite from the water, do board starts up on the board, then self-rescue techniques in the event that something goes wrong. We're going to start out by talking about the wind window. Within that window, there's different areas that create more or less power. The neutral zone can be defined as the area straight above your head or at 12 o'clock, down to 3 o'clock on one side and 9 o'clock on the other. In this plane, the kite has the least amount of power. To create more power with the kite, you dive the kite into the power zone. The power zone is located downwind of you, and this is where the majority of the power is found when flying the kite. The optimal conditions for kiteboarding are either sideshore winds blowing parallel to the beach or side onshore winds blowing at an angle from the water towards the land. Offshore winds, whether they be side offshore or directly offshore, are more dangerous for kiteboarding for two reasons. Offshore winds are not as steady as sideshore or side onshore winds, making it harder to control your kite. And they also blow you away from land in the event that the kite were to fail, the wind were to die or dramatically increase.
Hi, I'm Matt Nuzzo, coach for Real Kiteboarding. Today we're gonna take out our trainer kite and learn some basic kite control skills. So the proper way to steer your trainer kite is by pushing on one hand and pulling on the other. Push-pull motions are what's gonna make you steer the kite properly. If the kite pulls too hard or you're in danger, just let go of the bar and let the safety leash activate. The leash will completely depower the kite by pulling tension on one line and completely slacking the other line.
Okay, so we've just gotten done learning how to fly our trainer kite. You're familiar with the wind window, you're familiar with the power zone, and you're coming away from this experience knowing a lot about flying a kite. Let's take this and apply the same flying techniques to the more powerful 4-line and 5-line inflatable kites. We're gonna head back out onto the beach with Matt and Issa, learn how to rig these kites up, launch them, land them, fly them, and how all the different safety systems and power controls work on these kites.
On our 5-line setup, we have our 2 outside lines here. We've got our 2 center lines here, which will change the power. We have our 5th line, which runs right up the center of the kite.
You've learned to fly your trainer kite. You've applied those same flying and control techniques to the 4 and 5 line inflatables on the beach. Now we're gonna head onto the water using a harness. We're gonna learn to become comfortable with those kites in the water. We're gonna learn how to relaunch the kites from the water. We'll do powered body drags through the water, first straight downwind, then in both directions. And then we'll do water starts up onto the board, basic board riding, and followed up with a self-rescue drill. Let's take a look at the new 5-line kites and the benefits that they provide. 5-line kites have an additional line that runs from the center of the bar to the center of the leading edge of the kite. The rider's leash is attached to the other end of the 5th line. When the rider lets go of the bar, the kite will pull down onto its leading edge, flip upside down, and fall from the sky to the water. Life of a kiter fills in all the blanks that you may encounter after 2 to 4 weeks of riding. What happens if you pop a bladder? What happens if you rip your kite? What happens if you get a small ding on your board or if your bar is out of tune? Life of a kiter answers those questions with quick and easy steps to get you back on the water as a self-sufficient rider. Original got a beginner, getting in the weed.
the sink of the dish. Don't we?